Hello, welcome to this snapshot video. We're going to be covering three of the big US technology companies reporting earnings this week. Now, two of them, Apple and Facebook, are already pushing into record high territory as we anticipate those earnings reports. Tesla slightly underperforming, shares heading down a little bit, but still close to those record highs. When we're covering Facebook, really the fact that they've been able to dominate the social media market, they've been able to move over into other markets covered by the likes of Snapshot, other growth areas of the internet. They and Alphabet, the parent of Google, really are just dominating online marketing, online advertising. And so we're continuing to see strong growth in earnings, and that's the expectation leading into these results. With Apple, there is some concern about the supplies of the iPhone X moving into the next few quarters, but it does seem like there's very strong demand. So if they can fix those supply issues, then it looks like this actually, the next two models, in fact, the 8 and the X, could be a new driver of growth, particularly in areas like China where sales have been slowing. Now, Tesla, as I mentioned, slight underperformer, is really just a supply bottleneck, really, when it comes to the Model 3. Tesla need to up the ante and produce on a level that's going to get them to mass production. And it just seems like there's a slight hold up and that the other big auto manufacturers are catching up. But still, as I said, shares are close to record highs. We'll have a look at the charts now. Firstly, looking at the Tesla shares, we've got a weekly candlestick chart up on the screen here. Chance of a double top around the 390 level. We've seen some confirmation of that with a drop through these lows here, which was support around the 330 level. Next support up would look like these two lows here from earlier in the year, around 305. So basically the support zone from sort of 290, which was this long-term resistance term potential support, to 305. So that's a sort of $15 range, if you like, and 300 being the big one in the middle. Some signs that the market is rolling over and potentially turning to a sharper correction is that we've dropped through the 50 level on the RSI, showing loss of momentum, characteristic of downtrend, and that the 20-week moving average is also pointing downwards now. Switching gears to Facebook, stock looking very strong heading into the earnings. We've just hit record highs for the last couple of days. There was a false breakout of the consolidation area that we had here, but now we're pushing up above 180. And so stock in overbought territory, of course, but this is a strong uptrend, and you wouldn't look to bet against this share at this point, because the trend looks very strong. So if there is a pullback to the former resistance, that could act as support around 175. If there were some source of disappointment, then perhaps the old range around 165, down to this spike low around 162 could again act as support. Were those levels to give way, then we'd look at the previous consolidation zone with the support in around the big round number around 150. Apple shares, there are some signs of divergence where RSI is heading lower while prices are heading higher, but we've just taken out the old high at 165. So we look on course at the moment to head to higher numbers, potentially the 171 to 172, perhaps even the 175 round number as next targets to the top side. We'll just have to see if this RSI can break through the current signs of divergence after these results this week. Right, that's it for our snapshot video today. We're covering those big US technology companies who all have earnings this week. Let's see if those earnings results affect the current strong trends in place for most of them. Now, if you did like this video, please follow LCG on YouTube and Facebook.